I've gotta be honest, my mind's been in the gutter a lot lately. And I mean that quite literally. I've been thinking a lot about rain gutters, aka storm drains. Have you ever wondered what kind of life lives inside of these places? I mean, besides the occasional creepy clown, nobody really knows what's in there. So that's what we're going to find out today. Let's go. So like I said, I've wondered for quite some time if there's any sort of life that lives inside of storm drains. There is a lot of organic material in storm drains, such as leaves and grass clippings and things like that, but there's also a lot of chemicals and trash that get in there as well. Now, in order to get access to this water, I figured the easiest way to do it would be to get a fishing rod and fashion some sort of collecting device at the end. The collecting device was this test tube that I just drilled a small hole through. Before bringing it to the street, I wanted to test it out first to see if it would work. I put it in my bathtub here, and every time I dropped it in, I only got about 5 to 10 milliliters. That might not seem like a lot, but when we're looking for microscopic organisms, that is usually plenty to work with. So with the beta testing being pretty successful, I figured it was time to hit the road.
So I'm out here teaching my son how to fish today. Let's see if we can catch some good ones. So one of the tricks that I found is that if you lower it and then you bring it up just a little bit, it has just a tiny bit of water in it, but that gives it enough weight so that if you drop it again, it pulls up more water the next time. So there's actually a technique to this.
Well, keep telling yourself that.
Not that much water.
I probably ended up collecting about 100 to 150 milliliters. There was plenty of small debris, and so my hopes were pretty high that we were going to find something. So without further ado, let's take this under the microscope. So I wasn't really sure how much stuff we'd find in this sample. I mean, there's not a lot of light in this area, and there's probably not too many nutrients. But we were able to find quite a bunch of stuff. For example, there were a ton of vorticella. I was doing some research, and it turns out that vorticella are pretty common in places like this. They do a really good job at eating bacteria and breaking things down. One of the cool things about seeing certain microorganisms in abundance is that you get to see a lot of different parts of their life cycle. For example, I saw a lot of vorticella doing binary fission, which is their version of reproduction. I'm not sure if these guys were doing binary fission as well. Usually these vorticella split right down the side, but this one seems to be split at the top. Another fun thing to see was this spiral-shaped bacteria. And for a while, I thought that those were the only two things that were in this sample, just a bunch of vorticella and bacteria hanging out together. But to my surprise, another monster showed up on screen. I was zoomed in on a vorticella, and all of a sudden, I saw this gigantic rotifer. And I mean gigantic in a microscopic sense, if that makes sense. This thing measured at about 0.1 millimeters. I found a dead spider mite in this sample, and one of these rotifers ended up swimming up right next to it, so you can kind of get a sense of scale. Another fun thing I tried was looking at this guy under polarized light. There were a couple of other rotifers here as well. The last thing I saw in this sample was this ciliate, and it was really cool because it had a long trunk-like thing, or proboscis, or I'm not sure what you would call it. I tried looking it up in a couple of reference guides, and I narrowed it down between these two organisms that I have a difficult time pronouncing. but I think I'd need a better microscope to get a clearer picture of this guy. Well, now you know what lives inside a storm drain. Well, at least what lives inside of my storm drain. The microscopic world is so diverse that you could literally find so many different things, and so you should really try this out yourself with your own microscope. Big thanks to my Patreon supporters. If it wasn't for them, I wouldn't have been able to buy this handy-dandy fishing rod. Joining the Patreon helps me get better equipment, as well as you get bonus content and behind-the-scenes footage and stuff like that, so it's pretty fun. Anyway, thanks again for joining me on this small adventure Saturday, and I'll see you guys next time.
Alright, so this is the reel. And then you gotta hold it like that. And then you spin this part. Right there. You try.